This is Peggy Hall from thehealthyamerican.org, and I have a very important message for the corporate offices of Trader Joe's, of Whole Foods, of Target, of Walmart, Costco, Stater Brothers, CVS, Walgreens, and any other store that is doing business in the state of California. Let me be very clear. There is no mask mandate in California. There is no law that was issued by the governor requiring the wearing of a mask. In the first place, the governor cannot create law. He is not a lawmaker. He is an administrator, and he is in the executive branch of our state government, which is one of three co-equal branches of government. We have a legislature, and that creates law. And we have courts which uphold the law and also hold people accountable for breaking the law. And then we have an executive office, which is the governor, and that is an administrator who oversees agencies and departments in the state. The governor can direct the agencies and departments to issue orders. Let me be very clear. A governor cannot create law, and no law came from the governor's office requiring you in your store and your managers and your district managers and your cashiers to require and enforce any patron to wear a mask. Let's take just one moment, and I'm going to explain to you and I'm going to show you the guidance letter that came from the California Department of Public Health. Contrary to what you may have read in the media or heard on the news or heard from a neighbor or through the grapevine, the governor did not issue a mask mandate. He has no power to do so. Any public health orders come from a public health officer who is the office that has the legal authority in an emergency to issue a limited in scope and limited in time public order, not intended to enforce individual public behaviors. Let's be clear on this. I'm going to share my screen and I will let you see exactly where these public health orders are. And let's find them here, shall we? This is from the California Department of Public Health. This is not a legal document. I know that's not a legal document. There are no legal citations to laws. There are no legal citations to penalties or fines. It is not signed. It is not dated. There is no witness. There is no state stamp or seal, and it has not apparently been filed with the Secretary of State because it is not a legal document. This is a guidance letter. What does that word mean? It's a recommendation. It is not an order and it is not a law. I know that because the county attorney in Amador County provided a letter to that effect. And I'm going to read that for you. County Council, this is in California, has rendered the opinion that the CDPH, California Department of Public Health document is a guidance letter. And therefore, there is no criminal liability for those in violation. Now, you are going to be hearing from us because you're going to be seeing this letter attached to the communication that many individuals in California will be sending your corporate offices, your district managers, your local store managers. And we are here to educate you because apparently there's been some confusion. The governor did not issue a mandate. The governor has no legal authority to create law, and the governor did not create a law regarding masks. It's the exact opposite. This has been a relaxation of any previous orders, and I'm going to show you that in just a moment. The reason why this is so important to you to understand that no governor can create law, and the governor of California did not issue a mask mandate. As I just showed you, the legal language here is that it is a guidance letter with no force of law behind it. Why does that matter to you? Because you are breaking the law by forbidding patrons to enter your business establishment if they are not wearing a mask. And I'm going to show you exactly why that is. And I know that you at the corporate offices, and I know that the district managers and the managers and the cashiers do not want to be sued personally for liability and personally for breaking California Civil Code 51. Let's look at that, shall we? California Civil Code 51. Bear with me just one moment. And we are going to look at, I summarized it for you here, and California Civil Code 51. This way I can highlight all the important information. All persons within the jurisdiction of this state have the right to be free from any violence or intimidation or threat of violence committed against their persons or property because of political affiliation or on account of any characteristic listed or defined in subdivision B. Let's look at subdivision B, shall we? All persons within the jurisdiction of this state are free and equal. Those are very important words. We're going to return to those in a moment because I know as a business establishment in the state of California, you don't want to break this law and have lawsuits against you and have that be in the news. So let's help you understand the law, shall we? No matter what their sex, race, color, religion, for many people, wearing a mask is against their religious beliefs. Their ancestry, their national origin, their disability, or their medical condition, which you may not even inquire about. It may be claustrophobia, it may be asthma, it may be that they had a lung disease and they need to have a free flow of oxygen. It may be that they need to breathe. They do not need to disclose their medical condition to you because that is protected by HIPAA regulations, which I'm sure you are familiar with. So these individuals that are coming to your store without a mask have the right to be free from any intimidation, right? You can't harass these people that are coming to your store without a mask because they are entitled to the full and equal accommodations, advantages, facilities, privileges, or services in all business establishments of every kind whatsoever. Shall we memorize that like many Californians now are committing this California Civil Code 51 to memory because it's so important in the functioning of our civil society? That means you cannot ask them to stay outside while you shop for them. You cannot ask them to be on the curb while they do takeout, you do takeout service for them, or they call in and then drive by in their car. No. If you're allowing other people in your business establishment with a mask, you need to allow the others without a mask because they are protected by California Civil Code Section 51. You cannot intimidate them. Any intimidation will result in law enforcement being summoned. You may not discriminate against them because of their religious beliefs or their medical condition, which does not need to be disclosed. I just want to make sure we're very clear here. They are entitled to the full and equal accommodations, advantages, facilities, which means they can come inside and use your facilities. You cannot discriminate. I just want to be clear. Secondly, let's just review the fact that only a licensed medical professional is qualified to give medical advice, including the advice to wear a mask. I don't know if your cashiers are licensed medical professionals or your managers or your district managers or the people outside with the shopping carts or the baggers in the store. I doubt they are, and they are not allowed to give medical advice. That also carries a penalty if you are practicing medicine without a license. That's what number two says. It is an offense punishable by law. I know you don't want these lawsuits. I know you don't want to waste your time and money and be in the news with all of these negative repercussions. There is no law in California, no statutory law that was passed by our legislative body that requires anyone to wear a mask in any business establishment. Guidelines are not laws. Please repeat after me. Guidelines are not laws. One more time. Guidelines are not laws. So as we spoke about California, it should be civil code, equal access and accommodations in any business establishment, including Costco, including private clubs, whatsoever is protected by law. Any threat of intimidation in this matter will result in law enforcement being summoned. So I think we're clear. A governor cannot make law. A public health officer can issue, this is in the state of California, an emergency order, which is limited in scope and limited in time, and also has to be reviewed by a governing body. Your business establishment cannot refuse entry to any patron in the state of California if they are not wearing a mask. There is no law and there is no fine that you will get for allowing them to come in. We just looked, and I'll show you one more time. We will look once more at the, let's take a look here at the guidance from the state of California. Now, California Department of Public Health, June 18th, this is guidance. There is no, this is not a public order. There is no penal code associated with it. You as a business owner cannot be fined on this basis. You could be fined for other infractions if you have an unsafe workplace, for example, or other regulations that are on the books, so to speak. So here, all of these individuals are exempt from wearing a mask. So if you attempt to prevent a patron from entering your store because they are not wearing a mask, you are violating California Civil Code 51, and you are also discriminating against all of these individuals who do not need to disclose their condition to you. I want you to be very clear on that. Any person with a medical condition or a mental health condition, they may have anxiety, claustrophobia, asthma, difficulty breathing. This does not need to concern you. You cannot ask about it, and they do not need to disclose it. So if it obstructs the person's breathing, they do not need to wear a mask. Are you clear with me now? Corporate offices of Walmart and Costco and Target and Trader Joe's and Stater Brothers and Whole Foods and CVS and Walgreens and all other business establishments operating in the state of California. We already have lawsuits pending. And it would be so unfortunate if your names were added to those lawsuits. It would cost a lot of money. You would be in the news, and it's probably not the direction you want to go. You are also discriminating against people who are hearing impaired. It is very difficult for someone to understand any of your employees who have a mask on. Even if you are not hearing impaired, even if a patron is not hearing impaired, It impairs their hearing because of the mask. Now, even your employees do not need to wear a face covering if it is a risk for their work. Do you really want to take the risk of someone's face going up in flames because they have a cloth on their face, a spark, an ignition? That is going to be a very, very bad lawsuit with lots of hefty fines from OSHA. So anyone here that those are the ones that we are going to focus on right now. So I want you to be very, very clear that according to law, there is no law that requires anyone in the state of California to wear a mask. Further, you and your business establishments may not deny their entry. You may not harass them. You may not ask about their medical condition. You may not refuse service, and you may not make them stand outside while you shop or bring them their food. That is not free and equal access. More and more of our 40 million Californians are being alerted and educated to these very simple laws that are easy to understand, but apparently are very difficult for you and your corporate offices and your district managers and your local managers and your cashiers and your other employees to understand. So I do hope that this cleared things up for you. I look forward to bringing you more communication to help you understand the laws in California. Again, there is no regulation on the books that you will be fined for allowing a patron inside your business establishment if they are not wearing a mask. The health department cannot fine you. The sheriff cannot fine you because there is no fine that is going to be brought against a business establishment unless you deny entry. Now there can be a lawsuit. I'll be back with you again with more education and information to help you conduct your business lawfully in California.